In a separate video tutorial, I showed how you can load an SQL file that has time series data from your simulation, and you can load it into ResultsViewer Application or view it directly here in SketchUp. So when you do that, you're always viewing time series data for specific surfaces or meters or zones in a project. And there's sometimes you don't need it in time series, or you need it broken down a different way. And we have some tabular results that I neglected to mention. There's an HTM file when you run your simulation. And if you go to your status, you can see that here. This is an annual building utility performance summary. And that's actually just a piece of what it is. There's a lot more data below. So the top of this tells you what version of EnergyPlus you were running and when it was run, and the title of your project. And if you scroll down a little, you get total site and source energy summaries. You can look at your conversion factors for different types of fuel. Gives you some building information on your area, end uses, breakdown of for different types of loads. So you can go on and on. There's one, if you go back up to the top, there's a table of contents. So we're actually just looking at that piece here. There's actually tons of summaries, and I'm going to highlight just a few of them here. Envelope summary will list all of your building base surfaces, walls, floors, roofs, and will give you data about those, how it's, what direction it's facing, the area of the wall, how it's tilted, U factor or R factor. I guess U factor in this case, because there's a separate one for fenestration. So let me go back to our table of contents. Shading summary is also a really nice one. This looks at your fenestration surfaces and gives you a percentage that is sunlit at different times of year, at different times of day. So you have your solstices and your equinoxes here. So a lot of these could be really good if you quickly want to see what change of geometry or construction changes have done from one simulation to the next. Anyway, I'm not going to go through all these, but you can continue to look through these, and I believe there are more reports you can request beyond this. I launched this through the simulation status from the SketchUp plugin. If you also go to your results viewer and then click results viewer and launch your file, on the right-hand side, next to the welcome screen, you actually get this exact same HTM file that it just reads into here. So that's a good place to go if you don't want to search through the files that you have directly in the status, simulation status. So anyway, just didn't want that report to get neglected, because it's definitely a valuable report to quickly get information about your project. So that's really all there is for this tutorial.